In this video, we are going to see how to take backup and restore a database in MongoDB instance. As an administrator, it is our daily task to take backups daily or weekly basis. MongoDump tool is used to take backup of MongoDB database or collections. MongoRestore tool is used to restore database or collection on the target database server. MongoDump syntax. See, this is the MongoDump syntax. Here, options, we have more than 20 options. Few important and daily using options are authentication database of the username. Suppose if you want to take all databases backup, then just give MongoDump. It will create a dump directory. In that dump directory, it will create directories with the name of databases existed in the MongoDB server. Suppose if you want to take only single database backup, then give the MongoDB, then give -db and specify the database name. Username is name of the user, password for this user, out is path to store backup files, host is to provide the host name. URI is the connection string. Collection means, suppose if you want to take particular connection, then we have to provide the collection equals to the name. Query, here we have to provide JSON query, archive, operations log. Also, if you want to take DB users and roles, then use this parameter. Suppose if you want all collections except few collections, then you have to give this exclude collection. Now we are going to see how to take backups in MongoDB server. I have two MongoDB instances. One is MongoDB 1 and another is MongoDB 2 instance. Let's create a directory for backups. Mkdir backups. Now we are going to take backup of all the databases. Command is mongodump . Once we enter this one, it will create dump directory. In the dump directory, it will create directories with the name of databases present in this MongoDB server. MongoDB 1 instance. Switch to backups directory. Then run the command mongodump. See, it is creating. Backup of all the databases has been completed without any errors. Check the contents. See, it has created dump directory. Type the command ls. Now go to the directory. Cd. See, my database, my MongoDB instance contains this many databases. So it has created this many separate directories in the dump directory. Let's verify what is there in the directories. Cd underscore. See, it contains this many collections. Suppose address book is the one collection. This is metadata and this is the JSON file. This is the JSON file of metadata. Suppose if we want to take a single database backup, then use the command mongodump db equals to give the database name, and if you want to store in particular path, then give the out parameter equals to backups, then test, then give what this will do, it will take only test database backup to this path, home auto schools backups, then test, then it will create a directory test appending the date, then press enter. See, it contains only one collections. So dump has been completed successfully.
Let's verify ls. See, it has been created a directory for the test database. Switch to test and see. See, it has created with the current date. See, why? Because we have given this one. Let's verify the contents of this directory. See, it has created a test directory. In that, we will have backups. See, same files it contains. This is the way to take single database backup. Suppose if you want to take particular collection, then you use the command MongoDB, MongoDump, DB equals to R2 scores, then collection equals to address book, then press enter. It will take backup of this collection. See, it has taken backup of only this collection. It contains 5 documents. Let's verify. See, here we haven't provided dump directory. Let's see where it is stored. It is stored in dump directory only because we haven't provided. See, it is there. CD then R2 scores. See, it has taken only single collection backup. Now, suppose if you want to take backup of R2 schools database with the zip option, switch to backups directory, then mongodump db equals to R2 schools vzip and press enter. It is successful. Let's verify. Cd dump cd R2 scores. See, it has taken with compressed file format. See here. Okay. Now, take backup by using hostname. Mongo dump db equals to m201, here host equals to, it should be in quotes, provide your IP or your host name. Here my IP is 0.log, this is the local host. Provide port number 27017. Also provide the path, that is outfile path, that is backup files path, that is backups, then m201. This is going to take backup of this m201 database file, database backup of this host on with the port number 2701. It is going to store in this path. See, it has taken backup successfully for this host. It contains 50,000 plus documents. Let's verify. See, it has created directory. In that directory, backups are stored. M201. See, it has created one more directory because we have given here directory name here. See, it contains one collection, so it has taken backup of this people's collection. Until now, we have seen different ways to take backup of Mongo database and collections backup. Now we are going to restore MongoDB databases and collections. Clear the screen. First, we will restore MongoDB database and collections on local machine. Then we will perform restore operation on remote server also. Mongo restore is the tool used to restore MongoDB databases and collections. Suppose if you want to restore all the databases available in current directory, then use the command if the target instance doesn't have the databases, then it will restore whatever the data available in MongoDB dumps. But in my current database, it contains same data. Now give the command drop, then it will drop and restore them. See, it started and restoring these databases, examples M21 and Arthur Schools database. So it has restored 5 last documents successfully. 0 documents failed to restore. So we have performed restore operation on all the databases. Suppose if you want to perform particular database, then use the command mongo restore ns include equals to test drop. See what it is going to do, it is going to restore test database. Before that, it will drop the database and restore it. Total 99,999 documents restored successfully, 0 documents failed to restore, which means restore is successful. Suppose if you want to restore a single collection, then use the command mongo restore ns include equals to, here we have to provide collection name only, that is flights, in that we have flight data collection. If this collection exists, then execute it, then drop it, then give the hyphen hyphen drop. If it doesn't exist, then execute this command. But in my server, collection exists. I am going to drop and recreate it. See, no indexes to restore and restore has been completed successfully. Now we are going to restore a database present in current directory to remote MongoD instance. See, I have dumps in this MongoDB host. Now I am going to restore these dumps in remote host. That is, in this host I am going to restore. Come here, my IP is 192.168.152.141. Let's verify collections. Show DBs. MongoDB host contains only 3 databases. Now I am going to perform restore operation from this host to the MongoDB host. Command is mongo restore db equals to r2schools, then host equals to in quotes, provide the IP or host name. Close the quotes, then port equals to 07017, then provide the backup path, home r2schools backups dump, there it contains r2schools. Press enter. See, we are going to restore this database in this instance from this backup directory. Press enter. It has restored 1,194 documents. 0 documents failed to restore. let's verify this database and collections stored in remote host or not. See, this is the MongoDB 2 remote instance. Let's verify database has been created after restore or not. See, this database has restored successfully. Use R2 scores. Then verify list of the collections. Here it contains this many collections. Also verify the from the host. Use R2 scores. Show collections. See, same collections reflected in remote host also. So in this video we have covered how to take backup and restore a database in MongoDB server. For more MongoDB videos, please subscribe my channel. Thank you.